art video on the channel. It has been a while since I made a video like this. I think it's been like 2 weeks, but some things have changed. So I purchased a camera. So the quality of the video, hopefully is better. That's why it kind of took me, like a day or two to like kind of set everything up. Unfortunately, I need to connect it to my laptop. I need to download OBS and connect it to my laptop. Because right now I'm using my PC, so you might hear the PC in the background, but thankfully I'm not playing any games, so it's quiet for now. But yeah, I guess we'll see. Hopefully it's not too annoying in the background. But anyway, I can finally see myself, so that's a huge plus. I don't need to, like when I was recording on my phone, it was so annoying, and I only recorded 2 videos, and I'm already complaining. Like, God, man, why am I complaining? But yeah, I mean, having the camera, it's a lot easier now, for sure. But anyway, going to the main topic. So for today's video, I'm gonna be showcasing you guys 5 colognes in my collection and give you guys, detailed detailed review of of the colognes, kind of like how they smell like, like what occasion can you wear them, that type of thing. But as I mentioned before, I made 2 videos, cologne unboxing videos. And, yeah, man, this has become, like, my passion. Granted, it's crazy expensive, there are a lot of good ways, to be able to, afford these colognes at a much, much cheaper price online. Like, I've purchased most of my colognes all online, except for, like, 1 or 2 of them. I'm never doing that again because it was way too much. It's just, maybe a couple of them I got from like Macy's and Bloomingdale's. But that's because I had like a discount. I got it for a discounted price. But anyway, enough of that. Showcasing five random ones that I chose. So we're gonna start off with, and this one is probably a familiar one if you've seen the video. And that is L'Aramain's D'Etoile. See if I can focus up on the camera. So, the first live action ASMR that I made, it was an unboxing of this and another one. And I have to say, man, this is one of my favorite colognes, especially for how much it costs. So, before I get into that, let me do the note breakdown for you guys. So if I scroll down here, okay, so here it is. So I'm gonna like look at the notes on the left, so please forgive me if I'm looking at the camera. So the top notes are almond, jasmine, cypress. The middle notes are amber, cedarwood, and heliotrope. And then the base notes are vanilla, musk, and sandalwood. Dude, this beast right here, this is a clone of a very, very expensive and very popular fragrance, Parfums de Marly Layton. And man, oh man, I've smelled Layton before, and I actually have Layton Exclusive, the stronger version of it. And this smells almost identical to Layton, and this is a tenth of the price. If you were to buy a 100 milliliters or 3.4 Layton, right, Parfums de Marly Layton, it would cost you like $350, but this only costed me $30 or $35 after like shipping and tax and everything. Man, this was so good. I sprayed some on, right? And when I went to
Carolina Herrera, Cobalt, part.
cedar wood, and oak. And man, dude, this, bro, this cologne, this one is a bit pricey. Again, I buy all my colognes off of discounters, specifically, like mostly on like eBay, and I purchased this from this one seller that I buy from on eBay, Forever Lux. If you can, I can link it in the description if you guys want to check them out. But you know, you can buy these colognes for like $40, $50, sometimes even like $200 cheaper than the original, like MS, like the retail value. So far, like, I've purchased from them, like, multiple times. I'm talking minimum, like, 8 colognes from them, and they've all been authentic, like, 100%. I purchased a couple of expensive colognes from them, and one of them I will actually showcase to you guys, and this one I bought from them. I went to the store, I tried it compared to with this one, and it's the exact same in terms of longevity, smell, everything, right? And to check it out, like, there's multiple ways. It's difficult sometimes. Well, firstly, you want to check the batch code. You can't really, I don't think you can see it, but there's a number, there's a serial number on each cologne that you buy. There's one on the box that it comes with, and there's one on the bottom of every cologne. The first thing you gotta do is you gotta check if both those numbers on the box and on the bottom match. If they don't match, then there's a chance, a very big one, that you gotta fake. And also, you can, it is easy to fake one of these. It's not that hard, right? So some people say, like, you can grab like something sharp and kind of like scratch it, and if it peels off or if it like gets, you know, destroyed, then it's fake. But you know, if it doesn't, then it should be real. And then another way is from the smell, you know, spray it on you, test the longevity, and then go to a store, right? So like, what I would do is I would bring it with me to the store and I'd say, hey, look, I purchased this online. I just want to see if it's fake. Spray one on the left and then spray the one that they have, the original one, on the right, and then smell it from there. That's what I did with one of the colognes that I purchased. But okay, anyway, getting to this, dude, you can, the pink pepper, lavender, the plum, oh my god, bro, this is so, probably, I mean, all of them are like my favorite. I wear all of them, but this is definitely one of the best, like, spring summertime colognes, in my opinion. Not the best, but one of them, definitely top five. It smells so, like, it's like fresh, fruity. That sounds weird, but like seductive in a way, like fun. That's like the best way I could describe it. Like fresh, it's got some like fruits and fun. That's what it smells like. Could you wear this to work? Yeah, you could wear it to work. It's not like, it doesn't bother you. I spray a lot, and some colognes, they kind of give me like a headache when I spray too much. But this one, dude, I went off on this one time when I first got it to see, like, you know, to like test it and, you know, to see if it projects well or not, when I was like going to my friend's house. And dude, it, like, they loved it. I wasn't bothered by it at all. Very, very good. And longevity, so projection is good. Projection's very good, 7 out of 10. This will project so long as you spray a lot, but it's not like a beast mode fragrance. It's more like a, you know, apply it, smell nice type of cologne. In terms of how long it lasts me 5 hours on skin, on my clothes. It lasts me like 10, even more. Like I'll still smell it the next day, but on my skin absorbs the hell out of this thing. So I only get like 5 hours, but honestly, for my purposes, 5 hours is like more than enough, you know. And it is good, very, very good. But okay, moving on. Next up, we have Buffalo Gary. Let me see if I could. Okay, so we've got, let me do it like this way. Okay, sorry about that. I'll edit that, but we have Buffalo Gary Wood Essence. Okay, so I purchased this. I had like a $75 cash back or like rewards card from Bloomingdale's that I got as like a gift from someone, and it was expiring the end of the month, so I like went in to Bloomingdale's, I think like 2 weeks ago, and I went and got this for $60. You can get this online for $60. Don't buy it on retail. You know, it's like $100 or $120 there. You can get it for like $80 or $70 online. I got it for $60. I love it. I love this so much. This is, right now, it's one of my favorite scents that to wear, and the bottle is really nice. Buffalo Gary, I always wanted to try out one of their colognes, and I kept hearing like Glacial. They're it's like a light blue one, but then when I smelled this, I was like, yo, I have to get this. It's so good. But let me go over the notes with you guys. So the notes for Buffalo Gary Wood Essence. So the top notes are citrus with sugar, lemon zest, coriander leaf, cypress. Oh, sorry, this is the middle notes now. We're in the middle notes. Cypress, cedarwood, vetiver, and the base notes is benzoin. Man, benzoin kind of looks like one of those. It kind of looks like a dry, like yellow raisins. That's what it looks like in the picture. And my god, dude, cedarwood isn't like every cologne. Dude, cedarwood is like a very good cologne for. It's like a fresh, you know, like everyday type of cologne. But this cologne, man, oh, dude, it reminds me of, it reminds me of, like, Dior Sauvage, but, more woody and sweet, in a way. I love Dior Sauvage. I love it so much, but this one kind of smells a bit better, in my opinion. It kind of smells like you're walking in the forest, and you're walking by a bunch of, like, pine trees, and there's, like something sweet, it's like a sweet, foresty, fresh type of cologne. Super versatile. You could definitely wear this in any occasion. Work, school, going out, anything. And in any season, too. You can rock this spring, summer, fall, winter. Definitely mainly more in the spring, summer, and fall. Winter time, you want to wear something that has more like power, something more potent. In terms of projection, this one, you need to spray like 5+ to really get it projecting. Otherwise, it's more like a, you know, it's kind of like 1 to 2 feet projection for sure. In terms of like longevity, this, for me, on my skin lasts like 6 hours, and then on my clothes it lasts like the whole day. If you really want your cologne to last, like the smell, spray mostly on your clothes, or you could put like expensive. Actually, no, it's expensive, but it's like $100. But for a big bottle, and you can buy it for cheaper online for like $80 on eBay or like on Fragrant, like a fragrance.net or like your discounters. But this is definitely my number one favorite summertime cologne ever. I love this thing, and that is... Excuse me, I have to burp. Acqua di Gio Profundo. Dude, this thing is a beast. I absolutely love it. So, let me read you guys the notes. So, the notes for Acqua di Gio Profundo are... The top notes are C notes. Aquazone, bergamot, mandarin. The middle notes are rosemary, lavender, cypress, mastic, or lentisque. I don't know how to pronounce that. And the base notes are mineral notes, musk, patchouli, and amber. Bro, I blind purchased this. I'm so happy I did. Well, I looked at reviews first. I looked at reviews for all of them, all the clones that I have first, but I didn't go in and smell it. Dude, this smells literally like you're on a yacht on the ocean in, like, in the Mediterranean Sea. Maybe in Italy, right? You're, like, by, like, a, maybe, like, in Venice. Like in Venice, Italy, you're in the Mediterranean Sea on a boat, on a yacht. You got your linen shirt and your linen shorts, and then barefoot, drinking a cocktail with a lemon on it. Like, it smells like a summer vacation. It's so, so good. I love this thing. In terms of sillage, so. Can people smell it? Yes, they can. Bro, this thing will get 2 feet projection minimum. Definitely. It's on a beast mode fragrance. But it does project in terms of longevity on my skin. I get 6 hours, like 6 to 7. On my clothes, bro, dude, you'll get like day and a half. It's insane. This thing is so depending on your skin, sometimes you can get like, sometimes I'll get like 8 hours. Like if it's like a colder day, I'll get 8 hours. If it's a really hot day, actually no, the opposite actually. If it's a hot day and I'm like sweating, this thing, boom, it goes from like good or great to amazing. So, so good. It smells like sea salt with some wood. That's the best way I could describe it. You gotta get your nose on this. This is definitely 10 out of 10 requested by me. I'm guaranteeing you, you're gonna love this one. Acqua di Gio, like the whole line is fantastic. And man, this is probably my favorite of their line. I only have this one anyways, but I've smelt the other ones at the store, and I love this one. I'm so glad I bought this. But yeah, man, this is definitely great cologne. 10 out of 10. Perfect for summer, spring, and early fall. You don't want to wear this in late fall to winter. It's not really meant for that. Kind of defeats the purpose. It's like in those colder weathers, you want to wear something that's more sweet, dark, and kind of like pretty much it, like, you know, kind of like gourmand, like smells like it smells like cake or I don't know, something. But spring and summertime, you want to wear the more freshest. released. And this is the last one. I messed up the ordering beforehand, but this one is an expensive one. And it is definitely, it's probably the coolest, or not the, yeah, it's probably the coolest looking model that I have. And it just smells like perfection. Oh my god. And I can't wait to show it to you guys. So here it is. We have surge off 40 knots. Dude, this cologne, man. See if I could. It's kind of like bright, but wait, I mean, can I turn it down? Oh, I can't. Okay. Is much better now. Surge off 40 knots, or 40 knots, sorry. Dude, if you want the best and the most complex summer, like spring, summertime cologne, then literally look no further, man. This cologne, he's the guy. Like, he's your, you know that meme of like, you're not that guy? Like, this is the guy. This is it. This is so, so good. And I sprayed some on my skin yesterday. Yesterday. Keep in mind, on this right here. And I can still smell it. Or not, no, sorry. Not yesterday, that's a lie. This morning at like 10 a.m. And right now it's like, it's 8:30 p.m. as I'm recording this. I washed my hands, so like this part got washed too, and bro, it still smells, and it smells even better. It's ridiculous, dude. You've definitely never smelled anything like this, like, I guarantee it. So before that, let me read you guys the note breakdown. Oh, this was actually pretty basic, but breakdown for surge off 40 knots is, so woody notes, cedar wood, salt, seawater, and green notes. Now the notes are very similar to the other ones, but I don't know what surge off did. Like, When I smell this, I smell like they added like a hint of honey. Like, it's the opening, right? The opening. So, and you know what? I'm gonna spray some. Give you guys a little bit of like some of that good cap noises. I actually, you know what? Kind of going off like a tangent, like a side note here, but I actually quite like cap noises. I remember when I was younger, like in high school, I actually like, would watch videos, and you know what's crazy? You ever like watch like a ASMR, like a video on like a, this one YouTube channel, like an ASMR YouTube channel, and then fast forward and they're not there no more, like you don't see them anymore. Like, what the heck? They like delete their channel. It's sad, man. They were so good too, but it's like you can never see them again. That sucks. But okay, I want to spray it. My camera is running. It's not running low on battery, but it's about to, which is kind of annoying, but that's okay. I'm gonna spray it on again, and I give you guys, like, the note. It's so good, man. I have to spray this on, but here we go. Oh, dude. That's a good spray. Oh my god, bro. Already. Oh my god, dude. This thing smells so good. Okay, put it down, but right off the bat, glass. You scoop up the water, put some, like, I don't know, mint leaves in there, like mint green leaves, like tea leaves, and then you add in some honey in it, and like boil it and cook. I don't, not boil it, but heat it up a little bit and like mix it up. It's weird. It's like a blend of this fresh, this sweet and green. Like I've never smelled anything like this before. And dude, when I sprayed it on for the first time, I was like mind blown. And I tested it at the store before making this purchase. Because it's a lot of money. It's a lot of money. Especially at retail. It's an absurd amount of money. But man, oh man, is it good. If you want that next level fresh summertime, springtime, even fall, like all of fall too, then this is it. Like, look no further. This is literally like Acqua di Gio. On another level. In fact, you know what? I should make this the thumbnail. Yeah, okay, that's good enough. I'll figure it out later. But yeah, man. Definitely a 10 out of 10. If I were to list them up, my favorite from like the best to the my least favorite, and that's so hard because I love all of them, like literally, but oh man, okay, so here's the order out of the five that I have right now. Number one is Zirchow. Easy. Number two is, yeah, number two is Acqua di Gio Profundo. Number three is probably, you know what, okay. Number three is this, the Leighton Clone. My number three out of these five. And number four would be Wood Essence. I'm a sucker for like woody, sweet, fresh, clean type of clones. But I really love like the heavy, sweet, like rummy, kind of like, you know, smells like a cake or like, you know, sweet clones too. Like I love those too. And then number five, Cobalt. Again, though, these are all my top picks, like 100%.